friends of protection and control engineering. Today I'm gonna show you how to measure the knee point voltage of a current transformer core using a simple multimeter from the hardware store, since not everybody has a CT analyzer or an MVCT at hand. We don't use any current transformer, but a real exotic one, so it's getting really exciting. At the end of the video, I will show you how to easily determine the accuracy limit factor, ALF, out of the knee point voltage using our free Excel tool. I wish you a lot of fun and let's get started. What's the knee point voltage? The knee point voltage is defined by IEC 61862 Instrument Transformers Part 2, Additional Requirements for Current Transformers. The knee point is defined as the voltage at which a 10% increase in applied voltage increases the magnetizing current by 50%. What sounds like rocket science here is quite simple. The knee point voltage is reached when a further increase in voltage of 10% causes a current increase of 50%, and this since 1986, because that's the age of this old and easy definition. Let's have a look at the test setup. We connect an AC source to the secondary winding of our core and loop our multimeter into the circuit. As you can see, it's not done with a multimeter alone. As an AC source, you can use any second-hand transformer or an ordinary Schwerka. I think everyone has something like that in the garage. If you have a good clamp meter, you do not even have to hang directly into the circle. Important: during measurement, all other windings have to remain open. Because open cores normally always have to be avoided, we have to make sure with the force of the law that we only test according to all safety rules and only test out-of-order CTs. In the real world, it looks like this. I have connected the voltage output of my Compano with the terminals S1 and S2 of my core and inserted my cheap multimeter from the hardware store directly into the current path. I would say it's time for testing. Let's take a look at our current transformer first. This CT is very special because it has an exotic transformer ratio. A glance at the tie plate tells us the primary rated current is 14.4 amps and the secondary rated current is 0.075 amps. So here we have a 14.4 to 0.075 transformer in front of us, and that's what it makes so exciting. But why the strange ratio? That's quite simple. The entire performance of the CT is designed to work together with Woodward's WIC1 protection relay. Combined with a CT-fed protection relay, this core is able to perform an accuracy limit factor of 80 at a maximum error of 10%. So we can say we are actually dealing here with a 10P80 transformer with a rated power of 0.1 VA, which has been completely designed according to IEC 61862. The CT has four connections at the back and also four secondary connection terminals. The first two terminals, S1 and S2, are connected to the secondary winding of the core. Both terminals, D and C, are connected to a test winding for the later protection test. I will show you now how you can measure the knee point voltage of this core and what ALF factor this core actually provides. We are starting our test now by the value of 1 volt and increase the voltage in a slow and evenly way. Please don't mind about the German labels on the checkbox below. If you download our Excel tool, you will find an entire English version, of course. So all we have to do now is to find the value of the voltage when the current suddenly rises sharply. We keep on increasing the voltage. We are not shy. We can do this, and we always have an eye on the current. We have about
20 volts and the current still moves slowly higher and we keep on increasing the voltage. 35, 36, and suddenly it happens. The current starts to jump up and we find the voltage about 40 as starting point for our measurement in detail. So let's set this 40 volts as our current test point and note it to our checkbox below. We also note the resulting current of 31.7 milliamps. The new test point now is 44 volt, which is exactly 10% higher than the 40 volt, and the resulting excitation current is 47.5 milliamps. So if we increase the voltage to a value of 44 volts and the current is going to be exactly 47.5 milliamps, then we found our knee point voltage at 40 volts. If the current even will be higher, then we already left the knee point voltage behind us. So let's see what happens if we set 44 volts at the next test point. Wow, the current jumps up to over 52 milliamps and we were searching for a value about 47.5 milliamps, which means we already are too high and we have to go back a little. Since the 40 volt are already above of the knee point voltage, let's go back to 39 volts and we will see what happens. As we can see, the next test point is 42.9 volt. Okay, let's see what happens. Good, we have to go for 42.8 due to the resolution and we get a current of 42.4 milliamps. That's smaller than 44.4, so we are already a little bit too deep. So let's try 39.4 volt as next point. This seems to be the golden middle. We set the value and note it again in our checkbox. We measure a resulting current of 30.38 milliamps and we note this as well. Okay, the next test point is gonna be 43.34 volt. Again, we are not able to hit the perfect value, so I stay a little below and we see we are already very close to the expected current increase of 50%. Due to the resolution issue, we can even get one step higher and let's see what happens. Yes, and now we are above the 45.5 milliamps, which means we just found our knee point voltage by 39.4 volts. Let's take a look at the measurement with the CT analyzer. The miracle of Bern, as I like to call the CT analyzer, is of course able to do the whole test in a jiffy. The structure of the test circuit is very simple and also shown on the device itself. You can't go wrong. First of all, we wire the primary circuit. We have the connections P1 and P2 and just need to connect our CT in the right direction, of course, from P1 to P2. Now we wire the secondary circuits. Here we have the both connections S1, which are combined and then connected together to the terminal of the current transformer S1. The same thing we do for the two connections S2, which are plugged accordingly to the terminal point S2. That's it. The test circuit is now ready and the test with the CT analyzer can begin. I start the miracle of Bern and call the gods. Now that we have entered the CT data in advance, we start the test. We don't have a protection relay connected and skip the test of the connected load and start directly with the current transformer tests. Okay, the test begins. And now we're done. The miracle of Bern announces happily the result. Our knee point voltage is 37.955 volts. So let's say it's 38 volts. As we can see, our results are relatively close to each other, and it gets really interesting if we measure the entire magnetization curve in this way. I've prepared this in advance. In green, we see the original imported characteristic trend line of the CT analyzer, and in yellow, our own recorded characteristic. As we can see, everything from 10 volts upwards is pretty much in line. It's just this upper part that we need to estimate the knee point voltage. You can enter up to 3 curves in this Excel tool, which can be either 3 cores or 3 phases. And at the bottom, you can get the accuracy limit factor ALF calculated. Simply enter the knee point voltage, the secondary rated current, the rated power of the core, and the winding resistance of the core to obtain the result. I've done this in advance as well, and our ALF is about 30 at a rated power of 0.1.
This is the end, my friend. Thank you for watching. All registered members can download our free Excel tool on our page proconplanet.com. Please take note of the safety rules in the credits as well. Thank you for watching and enjoy the summer.